Ready? Start.
This cannot be confused with a situation whereby the pujari may perform individual functions at some other place, divorce these functions, and for which he may receive separate offerings. This is basically the essence of the matter, and since it has been very clearly and conclusively decided in the earlier compromise terms, there could be no question of reopening that issue. To this extent, therefore, the submission canvassed by the appellant's learned counsel that the suit itself as framed was not maintainable is fully justified. The matter, however, was taken to this court by the respondents being SLP within bracket C number 2109 of 1999, and on leave having been granted this court by a judgment and order dated 15-9-2004, noticed that even no substantial question of law was formulated by the High Court, whereupon the same was set aside and the matter was remitted to the High Court for formulating substantial questions of law. The High Court thereafter formulated the following substantial questions of law: whether both the High Courts ignored the weight of preponderating circumstances while construing the contents of compromise decree arrived at between the predecessors in title of the parties to the suit and allowed their judgments to be influenced by inconsequential matters, whether High Court would be justified in reappreciating the evidence and in coming to its own independent conclusion, whether both the courts below erred in misconstruing Exhibit P2, the compromise arrived at between the predecessors in title in question for purposes of ascertaining the foundation of the suit itself, and if so, whether that error is to be interfered with in the exercise of High Court's power under Section 100 of CPC. Both the aforementioned questions were answered by the High Court in the affirmative. It was of the view that as compromise decree was binding between the parties and the dispute between them was governed by the said compromise decree, the plaintiff's suit was not maintainable, stating it is clear from the conditions of performance of puja as per the terms of the compromise decree that the right of performing puja during the term of Nilava and Alava is conferred upon the father of the first defendant, and the puja during that term has to be performed by the father of the first defendant with the assistance of the father of the plaintiffs, and no right has been conferred and regarding the offerings made by the devotees so far as the perishable articles are concerned, they are to be divided equally, and non-perishable offerings such as gold, silver, dakshina, cash, etc., which are not perishable, offered individually to the father of the first defendant shall be taken by him exclusively, and no such offerings shall be given to Paraiya Alaiya Hittalmani, that is the father.